What's up, guys? It is time for another DIY video. Now, I'm excited about this one because I cannot wait until I get all of that bottom paint off of the boat there. And that is gonna be the project for today. So if you're not familiar with what is behind me, that is our 1991 Corsair F27 Trimaran. It is a definite project. It needs a lot of work, and that's what these videos are about. So what I've done up until this point is repair interior hull damage from the inside. Now that that's done, I have to inspect the hull from the outside, but that bottom paint right there is preventing me from doing a proper inspection, so it has to come off. If you guys have watched any of our previous DIY videos, you guys know how much I love removing bottom paint. Now that is sarcasm, but the fact that this boat doesn't have a lot of wetted surface is definitely going to be a saving grace. Also, the fact that it's in my side yard here at my house, that's gonna help as well, because I'm not in a boatyard somewhere. I'm somewhere more comfortable where I can take my time and work on the boat. So also, I don't think there's a lot of bottom paint on the hull. I think it's probably about two coats or perhaps even one on the underside. So I think without further ado, let's go ahead and show you my setup and let's get to work. So what I got going on right now, it's very simple. It's just a shop vac that has a hose extension that is duct taped to my random orbit sander right there. Now, this is definitely not the quickest method for removing bottom paint, but it is probably one of the safest. Now, if you guys are familiar with these Corsair boats, the hull laminate isn't very thick. It's a cored boat. So I don't want to accidentally punch through or eat away at that exterior laminate. I just want to go down to the gel coat. So having the random orbit sander is gonna help with that, because it's gonna prevent me from taking off too much. You know, I could use a grinder or something like that, but again, I wanna play it safe. I'm gonna use the random orbit sander even though it's slower. Another option I have at my disposal is this Totalstrip paint remover from Totalboat. Now, this is a gel paint stripper, and I tested it on the starboard AMA here. And as you guys can see, you know, it works. It definitely works, but this was two coats. I had to do it twice and it got down to gel coat, but there's still a little bit of sanding that has to be done anyway. Even after using the paint stripper, I'm still gonna have to do a bit of sanding over the hull. So I figured, why not just keep it simple right now and just start off by sanding and see how fast that goes. If it's not going fast enough, I've got a gallon of that paint stripper right there. I can, you know, switch it up and change my strategy as I go. So I think without further ado, let's go ahead and get to work. Start it up. All right, guys, this is where we're at. I've got almost half of the main hull done, both sides, as well as underneath, obviously. You guys might wonder why I didn't take this all the way down to gel coat. That was certainly my plan. And one of the reasons is time. The other reason is when this barrier coat was applied, I believe the previous owner sanded the gel coat a lot, to the point where the gel coat is really thin underneath the waterline here. So I decided, hey, you know what? This barrier coat is probably good. It's an epoxy barrier coat. It's permanent. It's like one with the gel coat. So I'm gonna be able to assess the damage even with the barrier coat. So I'm not too worried about that, but I figured I'm not gonna take it all the way down to gel coat because I don't wanna sand too much into the fiberglass. You can see that up here, you know, sanding it down to gel coat, I went all the way through to the fiberglass. This is about when I decided to stop going all the way down to the gel coat and just, you know, be fine with the barrier coat. You can see there's repairs done by the previous owner, and they all look to be okay. They're not horrible. At least they're watertight. But yeah, this is where we're at. I went ahead and moved the tarp, and we're gonna do that last section down here. Now, luckily, when the previous owner painted the bottom paint on, he didn't actually paint underneath the bunks, so I have less of a job to do than, you know, what it might look like. So it's just barrier coat right there where the bunks were. So it's about noon right now. I've been working on this for a couple hours now. I'm pretty optimistic that I'm gonna get the main hull done today. fully sanded, and then I'll get the AMAs done probably tomorrow. But yeah, I mean, this is actually going quicker than I had thought it was gonna go. Certainly, you know, a far cry from sanding the bottom paint off Somnium. If you guys watch my videos on that, this is a lot quicker. There's a lot less bottom paint to sand, so that's good. And there's also a lot less wetted surface area, because obviously this is a trimaran. You know, there's not a lot of area below the waterline. Anyway, let's stop talking and let's get to work. All right, guys, it's the next day, and that was definitely not the easiest thing in the world, but it did go relatively quickly. And today I'm gonna try something different. So I talked about the Totalboat paint stripper. So yesterday I sanded off all of the main hull, and I am going to try the stripper on the two AMAs. So let's go ahead and take a look at what I got done yesterday. So as you can see, you know, I got the entirety of the main hull sanded all the way down to barrier coat. Certainly a lot of work, a lot of messy, dusty work. And even though I had my vacuum cleaner hooked up to my sander down there, dust still got everywhere, and I'm not like super duper happy about it. So I basically ended the day covered in dust, and even though I was wearing a coverall, you know, there was still dust in my hair, on my hands, on my feet. There's dust all over the tarp, there's dust all over, you know, the vacuum cleaner. And part of the issue was that the vacuum cleaner kept clogging, and then it would stop sucking up the dust, and then I'd have to try to unclog it. Well, trying to unclog it ended up meaning you got more dust everywhere, because you had to open it up, you had to like bang out the filter into the thing. Basically, it's just, you know, horrible, dusty job. There's nothing good about it. Anyway, I'm just not a fan of traditional antifouling. I've sanded this stuff. This is the third boat that I've done it on. You know, I did it on Somnium, then Freebie, and then this one. And I just hate the stuff. I really, really do. I just think it's a very poor solution to the problem of growth on boats' hulls. I think there's better solutions out there. Putting a coating on the bottom of your boat that's meant to be recoated in a year or two and sanded or whatever, it's not a permanent coating, but it has poison essentially in it that kills marine life. It just creates a problem. It creates this problem where eventually somebody is going to have to sand it off, whether it be you or someone you pay to do it. Somebody's going to have to remove it. They're going to be exposed to this stuff. It's never good. It's going to go into the environment anyway, whether it goes into the ocean from being on the boat or whether it goes into the ground from, you know, people sanding it off. And even though their best efforts, they're collecting it, stuff still goes into the environment. So it's just, it's not a good situation. This is something that people do on their yachts every year or two, because that's how this stuff is made. That's how this stuff is designed. And people just do it over and over and over again. And whether they do it themselves or they pay people to do it, they don't think about it. I don't know. That's my rant. You know, I think there's better solutions. And I personally will never paint a boat with traditional antifouling again, because I've dealt with it enough that I realize that I hate the stuff. So what we're gonna do with this Corsair is we're going to do a homemade DIY copper antifouling. It's gonna be similar to copper coat, but it's not gonna be that brand. And I would rather have that, because it's gonna be a permanent coating, even if it's not as effective as some of this antifouling, because I mean, I think that's the trade-off. I'd rather have something that maybe you have to clean a little bit more when it's in the water, because I'd rather have that than ever have to do this again. Sanding antifouling sucks. Anyway, today we're not gonna be sanding. Today we're gonna be using a chemical stripper. And even that is a different solution to removing this stuff that I wish I didn't have to do. I wish I didn't have to use a chemical to remove a poison that's on my boat. But this is the hand I've been dealt. I didn't put this stuff on here. So let's go ahead and remove it. And hopefully this video is going to be interesting for you guys. It's kind of a side-by-side comparison to, you know, sanding off the bottom paint versus using a chemical stripper. we're gonna see how it works. I've got all this stuff for the chemical stripper. Let's go ahead and clean up a little bit and then we'll get to that. All right guys, so this is what I am going to be using as the stripper. This is Totalboat Totalstrip paint remover. As you can see, it strips varnish, topside, and antifouling paints. Should remove multiple layers per application and could work in as little as 15 minutes. Now, I did try it at 15 minutes and I think I want to leave it on a little bit longer. The biggest thing is, this is why I was a little bit hesitant to use it, may cause cancer, may damage fertility or the unborn child. Obviously, this stuff is not to be messed with. So that was kind of my hesitation for, you know, using the chemical stripper. You know, obviously, you know, I'm dealing with essentially poison that's on my boat and I need to remove that poison with another chemical that, you know, is potentially as bad as what's already on the boat. So kind of stuck between a rock and a hard place. I do want to say Totalboat did send this out to me to try for free. So I want to thank Totalboat for that. Hopefully it's a good product. Hopefully it works well, but obviously, you know, you have to abide by the precautionary measures and, you know, respect the stuff for what it is. Let's go ahead and get started. All right, guys, so I've got one coat of stripper on the starboard ama. I'm not gonna cover it because the instructions say that it's not necessary to cover it if you've got three coats or less that you're trying to remove of bottom paint. So yeah, I don't think I have more than three coats on here. So we're not gonna cover it. We're just gonna give it some time to work. And I think it's gonna take about, from what it seems like in the instructions, about 15 minutes per layer. So I'm gonna give it about an hour. I might come back in a little bit and put one more coat on here, just to give it some more oomph. But let's go ahead and do the port ama now. All right guys, there's not really much to look at, but I did put two coats of stripper on both of the amas now. For what it's worth so far, this has been a much more enjoyable process. As you can see, I'm not wearing a coverall. I'm not wearing a respirator. All I had on was some gloves and, you know, my glasses for eye protection. The good thing about this stripper is it's more of a gel. So, you know, I put a tarp down originally thinking that it might drip as I'm rolling it on there. Just a side note, rolling it on worked really well on a surface that's inverted like this. But I was expecting a little bit of drippage. I don't know that there was any, so I didn't actually need to move the tarp while I was painting because it didn't drip. So that is pretty cool. It's not sagging, it's on there. Now, I actually need to go get some more gloves, so I'm gonna run to the hardware store, and by the time I get back, it should be ready to start scraping. It's been about an hour now. So, hoping that this bottom paint will just scrape right off. And if it does, then I think I will determine that this stuff is better than sanding, but that is still yet to be determined. Let's see. Unfortunately, that's kind of what I feared. It got most of it off here, but as you can see, there's still some residue there. Wondering if I just need to let it sit longer, so that's what I'm gonna do. I just wanna mention, it seems to be working better on areas maybe that are more out of the sun. So on the inner part of the ama here, let me show you guys, it seems like it's coming off pretty good. So like that's kinda what I expected right there, the way that comes off. That's nice. And then, you know, obviously there is residue, but it's not a crazy amount. It's gonna be really, really quick to sand off. The other side, however, might be that the bottom paint's thicker here, but it just doesn't seem to be cooperating as much.
it's not coming off as cleanly or as easily. I'm having to use more pressure. It actually isn't really in the sun here either, so I think it's just a question of the thickness of the paint. Previous owner probably put the paint on thicker on the waterline on the exterior portion of the Amas. Alright guys, I just finished scraping, and as you guys can see, there's still, you know, a decent amount of bottom paint on the hull. I was definitely hoping for a little bit better performance, but and as you guys can see, there's a lot of bottom paint down there on the tarp. So, I mean, it did something, but I'm a little underwhelmed, to be quite honest. So I think maybe if you have a boat that has, you know, 10 layers of bottom paint on it, you know, it's been bottom painted every year without much sanding, and it's just got, you know, a giant thick layer of bottom paint on it, maybe this stuff would be, you know, a little bit better for that. But I think for this purpose, considering it doesn't completely remove it down to gel coat, I don't know that it was worth it doing it, because I'm pretty sure that if I had just started sanding, yeah, it would have been messier potentially. I mean, this is still pretty messy, and still I created some dust that I was like, maybe I should be wearing a respirator, which I probably should have been. But I feel like if I just would have started immediately and started sanding, I would have already had one AMA done, and I'd probably be starting to work on the other AMA. And as you guys can see, I don't have one AMA done. So yeah, I mean, it's more complication. I'm gonna have to scrape this AMA here, and then I'm gonna have to go back and sand everything again. So I've still got to suit up in the coverall, put on the respirator, hook up the vacuum, clean out the vacuum, because my vacuum is like, there's just black. There's black everywhere in it. Like, I've got to clean it first, and then it's gonna get dirty again. But I've got to do that, and go back and sand everything, you know? I think it's just personal preference, really. The paint stripper definitely does work. Maybe I would have seen better results had I used plastic, but then that's, again, that's another complication and another step. I don't think the paint stripper is the issue. I don't think the sanding is the issue. I think the problem is freaking bottom paint. I hate it. I guess all I can do now is scrape the second hull and then plan to start sanding. Let's do it. Start it up. Alrighty, I just want to show you guys, we are down to gel coat on the AMAs because there was no barrier coat there. And then on the main hull, we are down to barrier coat with, you know, a few patches of gel coat and a little bit of fiberglass poking through in some areas. But yeah, I mean, that was pretty much a 2-day job down below here. That's the repair I made. I'm probably gonna add a little bit more glass to that eventually, but you know, it's watertight for now. And then after that, I just want to show you guys, there really is no evidence that I can see of any external damage. Now on the inside, the damage was all in this area right here, and there really is no evidence of that on the outside. So I think we're in the clear on that. That's really, really good news that I don't have to do any more glass work on the outside here. I'm really happy about that. All right guys, so there's been a time jump, and as you can see behind me, the boat is back on the trailer, and she's tucked back into a narrow spot in
the side of my yard here, and she's taking up way less room, which is a huge plus. A lot of work got her to this point though, including reglassing the floors inside the boat, as well as redoing the bunks on the trailer so that she would sit properly on the trailer and be supported properly. All of that though is gonna be the topic of the next DIY video that I put out, because this video is already too long, so stay tuned for that one. So as always guys, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, leave a comment down below, subscribe if you haven't already, and hit that notification bell if you wanna know each and every time we drop a video. See you guys. I've got it right and I got it wrong.